Hey y'all, what is up? Happy fall. I am so pumped to say that. I have been looking forward to fall. I just feel like we all just need something to look forward to. It's all about the small things, right? I'm super pumped because for today's video, I am sharing with you my favorite eyeshadow palettes for fall. So let's go ahead and get into it. The first one that I'm gonna mention is what I am wearing on my eyes right now. This is Dose of Colors Pretty Cool. This is a palette that lives in my client kit, so I don't use it on myself at all, but you know, within my move and just trying to get inspired using some products that I already have, I figured, you know what? This palette is dope. I use this a lot when working on clients, and I know when a lot of black girls in particular, you see palettes like this and you automatically think, oh my God, I can't wear this. Yes, you can, okay? Now you're probably looking at it and think, I don't get any type of fall vibes from this. Why are you saying this is a fall eyeshadow palette? Because I know traditionally, when we think of fall eyeshadow palettes, we think of the warm tones, the oranges, the reds, the browns, the really, really deep, deep, warm, burnt tones. That is not this. But the reason why I say this is just a good palette all around. Dose of Colors does an excellent job with their formula. I definitely want more of these, but this is a good old neutral. But as you see, it's neutral on the eyes, but when you pair it with a fall vampy lip color, it's a banger. So if you are someone who's afraid of cool tones, try this first. I think it's a great introductory and they are all matte. So, I mean, it's foolproof. You can't screw it up. Next up, Vizart. I had to go digging for my Vizart palette, Dark Edit. Absolutely love this. Okay, now this for sure screams fall. You have your orange, your purples, your burnt oranges, your green, olive tones. This is a beautiful palette. And I love their little mini palette too. I just think that's so cute. Oops, time to eat soon. Next up, Huda Beauty Desert Dusk. At the time of me filming this right now, this palette is half off. I have no idea if it will be. I know her foundation was half off too, so I don't know if she's getting ready to discontinue those or what the deal is. However, to me, this screams fall. Now, I'm not a fan of the glitters in this palette. I just don't like glitters and palettes in general, but I love this. These, all, like basically all of this over here, and I like these over here, but this to me is just 100% fall. I think this is a beautiful palette. I had to at one point hide this from me because I was using it that often. It's a rare occasion that I keep doing the same eyeshadow look, but with this palette, I just love the look that I created with it. I just kept doing it over and over. So absolutely love this palette. The next one, ooh, I should have checked to see if it is discontinued? I don't know. If it is, I'm sure quite a few of you probably have it, but we're kicking it old school. Tartlet in Bloom, again, another palette that is black girl, brown girl friendly, and if you want an introduction into cool tones, this is it. I wore this palette out. This is just a beautiful, beautiful. This gives me those grungy, dark fall nights. That's what this gives me. I absolutely love it. Again, you can pair it with a dark lip that's more of a fall tone and it will just bring the whole look to life. Me personally, I love doing a neutral kind of smoky, cool tone look and then just really bringing it to life with a plum or just a really, really dark vampy shade. Beautiful. This is a stunning palette and I think it is great for fall. Next up here, we have Juvia's Place Nomad. Okay, these greens though, the greens in here are beautiful. I love this olive shade, this grayish, it's like a gray smoke tone, beautiful. You have another green here. You've got some oranges and mustards and you have your neutral tone up there. This is a beautiful palette, it's affordable. When I look at this to me, it just screams, yes, fall, we're wearing this all October long. Absolutely beautiful. Now the next one's probably gonna throw a few of you off just because of when it came out, but just hear me out. So Natasha Denona Bronze Palette. Now, I understand that this came out in summer and this was supposed to be her summer bronzy, get your whole summer look. When I saw this, I was very confused because when I look at this, to me it screams fall. tell me in the comments if it's just me, but to me, this screams like a fall palette, and I don't understand why she came out with glam for her fall. Well, I mean, I see it, but I think she should have done this as fall and then glam as winter. I don't know, maybe it's just me, but I think this is a beautiful palette just in general. It's one of my favorites, and you can pull just a lot of stunning fall looks with this. So this for sure, absolutely rocking this all fall long. And then the last one, I believe I have mentioned this in every fall related makeup video since I've owned it. I've probably had it for 3, maybe 4 years now. I know it's a controversial brand. It's not a brand that I buy from on the regular basis, but the Morphe palette, 3502. This is just the epitome of fall. I mean, you can't look at this and not think, yep, this is a fall palette. This is my pumpkin spice latte in a palette. This palette is gorgeous, it's beautiful, it's stunning. I'm someone that has zero issues as far as with their eyeshadow palettes working for me. However, this is the only one that I have. Had a casualty, there's black here. One of the kids in my family knocked it off the table and no one knows who did it. And I picked it up one day and there was a bunch of black eyeshadow all over the place. But anywho, y'all know how kids are. This is just fall in a palette. You have your beautiful oranges, you have your browns, you have a couple of purples in there. It's just a stunning palette and I am excited to play in this. So that is going to wrap up my favorite palettes for fall time. Of course, you guys, you can use any of your eyeshadow palettes whenever you want, but when I think of fall and fall makeup, this is just where my mind goes. So down below, I want to hear your thoughts. I want to hear all of your favorite eyeshadow palettes that you like for fall. Also, if there are any palettes that you feel like maybe just came out in the wrong season, let me know down below because I'd be curious to hear your thoughts on that as well, okay? You guys know the deal. Keep it simple and I will see you in the next video. Peace.